Yo, what is going on, guys? My name is Pokeballer Luke, and welcome to the NPA Season 2 Playoffs Round 2 Battle against Insane Vampanese and the San Diego Charizards. Now, before anything else, I want to just tell you guys to check out Vump and all his channels and Twitch and Twitter, all in the links in the description below. And second off, obviously there was no battle last week. That's because I had a bye. I basically had two bye weeks. One, there was like a week in between regular season and playoffs. And then after that, since I was the top of my division, I actually got a week break. So now we're going against Vump. And Vump was Season 1's champion. He's a very good battler. And I'm extremely nervous. He has Mega Charizard, which is probably one of the best Megas out there. Now, of course, for good luck, like, who would we be? I would not be Luke if I didn't pick Music number 7. It's brought us a lot of good luck recently. So, we're going to do this, guys. We're going to work together. Go ahead, and I'll show you the team now. Today, we have Zatu. Oh, how could I forget? This team has a gimmick, and that gimmick is Trick Room. I have not run Trick Room once this entire season, but this time I am running Trick Room, and we have Aromatisse, which is going to be our lead. We have Donphan, Cofagrigus. Cofagrigus, of course, can set up Trick Room as well. We have Mega Medicham, and then, most importantly, we have Hydreigon, which in Trick Room can basically Oko everything he has except for Hippowdon. And then last we have Zatu, which is another Trick Room setter, and a good, you know, magic bounce is always good. So we're gonna pick that. That's our team. We're gonna pick our team. I'm hella nervous, like I said. I'm gonna have to take a picture of Vump's team real quick. Alright, so oh my god, he brought Ferrothorn and Hippowdon. That's the worst possible thing. But it's okay, we can make it work. Okay. So our lead, like I said before, is going to be Aromatisse. Followed by that, you know, it doesn't really matter. I guess he can have Whirlwind or whatever. So if he wants to Whirlwind us and anything, we'll go into Hydreigon. Cofagrigus, of course, Medicham. He has his Charizard. Starmie is scary, of course. He has, Mien Chao? Isn't that what it's called? And then also Helioptile, so it's, I'm scared, guys. I really am. My phone, I forgot it's on, like, low battery mode. That's gonna be annoying. Let me actually turn off a low battery mode real quick. Okay, 1 second, guys. It's been so long since I've recorded. I'm glad to be back. I've been kind of down lately. So, you know, being back is gonna help me a lot. That's the lack of videos, basically. Okay, I got low power mode turned off. Let me open up the picture. There we go. Okay. Yeah, let's go. Let's go, guys. Let's get it. I'm so nervous. I really am. I want to win Season 2. Obviously, there's no guarantee that even if we win this battle, that we'll win Season 2. But I want to try hard. I want to work for it. I've had such a vast improvement in my battle skills this entire season, so winning would be amazing. Like I said before, though, I know Vump is a very good battler. And he's also a really, really awesome friend of mine. He's done a lot in the past to help me out when I've been in, like, trouble and stuff. So if he wins, you know, I'll be just as happy. But with that said, here we go. Here we go, guys. I'm so nervous, man. You have no idea. Issuing a challenge. He's going to lead with Mien Chao. Okay, so he's got the fake out. That's annoying. I'm supposed to Trick Room turn one, right? I mean, he might actually switch out, to be honest. I could go into Cofagrigus. Because, like, he's not going to be able to touch that at all. I mean, I don't see why. He's going to just stay in and go for the... Yeah, I'll go into Cofagrigus. No, he has knockoff, doesn't he? Right, I'm going to stay in. I'm going to eat the fake out. Next turn, we'll get Trick Room up. So, we'll do that. Man, dude, you guys have no idea how nervous I am. This is going to be a crazy battle, you know? If the gimmick works, Hydreigon, like I said, can Oko everything he has. Except for Hippowdon. I was going to go for the U-turn, straight off. Alright, that's fine by me. Okay, so here comes the first Trick Room, I guess. Have some brisk iced tea to help quench my thirst. Let's turn on the volume a bit. Okay. I don't know what he's going to go into. Potentially Ferrothorn. If he goes into Ferrothorn, I've hit him Power Fire. But rather, I'd still go into... Yeah, I'm going to go into Zatu here. For the reason that... Like, I don't want him to get rocks up, because I want Donphan to maintain its sturdy. That's really important to me. So, we get the Trick Room up. We're at almost full health after Leftovers recovery, and we can go into Zatu, which, you know, a lot of people don't know that Zatu actually has Magic Bounce, so that's my thought process here, right? So, we're gonna go into Zatu now. Let's see if he throws up the rocks. My heart is beating so fast, you guys have no idea. Oh god, it's... I don't think my heart has ever been beating this fast in a battle, except for the battle where I went against Shady Penguin, which you guys can check that out. It was not that amazing of a battle, but I put up a fight, so... I have battled Shady before. Oh, why am I so nervous, guys? You have no idea. But yeah, I can't let him get up rocks. Donphan, you know, one, with Sturdy, it can eat a Flare Blitz from a plus one Charizard, which is extremely scary. He's probably just like, oh my god, Trick Room, because, like, who expected that? I've never run Trick Room ever. This is completely new. Honestly, I don't have very much experience with Trick Room in the first place, so. Alright, we withdraw Aromatisse, and we're going to go into Zatu here. He's going for the Leech Seed, and then he's going to Magic Bounce back him. Now, we do have Heat Wave here. Question is, does he go into something else? I think it's definitely safest for me to go for the Heat Wave here. I could go for a Grass Knot. I could potentially go for a Grass Knot if his Starmie comes out, I guess. I could just go for Psychic to get off some good damage. I'm gonna go for the Heat Wave. I don't want to risk anything. No point in making some sort of huge prediction this early on. Unfortunately, now Magic Bounce is kind of spoiled for a Leech Seed, something that wasn't that important. I could have totally stayed in and used Fire, whatever it's called, HP Fire. But, you know, it is what it is. We're here now. So everything on a team is kind of really fast because of Trick Room. Well, when Trick Room's up. I could have made a switch here to Hydreigon or something. I don't know, I guess we'll have to see what he does. This should do about 70% to him. I do have extra belt. But I don't think it's a confirmed Oko. I don't know what that sound was. Thanks, Windows 10. Oh, Adobe update. Yeah, I really care. Oh, he's going to withdraw, of course. Alright, makes sense. He's going to go into Charizard. Yep. Okay. Charizard is so scary, you have no idea. We're going to go for our Heat Wave now. Obviously, it's not going to do much at all. Okay, so at this point, we have, that was the second turn of Trick Room, so we have two more. What do I do here? I'm gonna go into Aromatisse. No. This puts us in a bad position. Charizard, like I said, is just scary, man. This thing, it's scary. It really is. Do I just go for the psychic? Obviously, I don't want to break Donphan Sturdy. Like I said, that's really important. Could go into Cofagrigus. Cofagrigus, hell, okay, he doesn't have Alakazam, so Cofagrigus. I mean, Alakazam could be carrying Shadow Ball, but I guess I'm gonna switch into. I don't want to Dragon Dance. I really think he's gonna Dragon Dance. Okay, we'll go into Aromatisse. We'll go into Cofagrigus. Ooh, am I nervous, guys? You have no idea. Actually, we outsped. I don't think that matters. I mean, we couldn't have hit him too hard, so. He's gonna Mega Evolve here, of course. Charizard X is really, it's honestly, so, okay, he's going for the Roost, actually. Okay, knowing that, I can go for, like, a Shadow Ball or whatever here. And then Trick Room next turn. If I went into Hydreigon, man, it would have been over. so yeah, I'll go for the, what is more? I guess Dark Pulse has a chance to, like, he could potentially go into, what's it called? Helioptile to eat the Shadow Ball because it's normal type, right? It's normal type, right? Pretty sure it is. So I'll go for the Dark Pulse here. Obviously, like I said, bring me out speeding. Man, I didn't expect him to roost, right? I expected him to, like, set up on me. We don't get the early Hydreigon sweep, at least. We'll see how it goes, though. My goal is to not get 6-0'd more than anything. I mean, obviously, I'm trying to win more than anything, I guess, but I don't want to get swept. I've put up such a good fight this entire season. I don't want to just be humiliated. But either way, it is what it is. So he's clearly thinking about what to do. Let's see. I'm still so nervous. It's been like almost 10 minutes. All right, we're going for the Dark Pulse here. Maybe we'll get a flinch. Swords Dance. Oh, okay. So he is Swords Dance Charizard. Alrighty. That is not expected. Okay, so... that is so not expected. I don't want to sack anything. I cannot sack a single thing. I'm going to set up Trick Room here. I guess like I have to saw... How important is Cofagrigus? It completely walls me in chat. Or knockoff, I guess, but... I don't want to just sack Cofag. He does so well. Zatu helps because it has, you know, Heat Wave, and it also has Grass Knot. Aromatisse is pretty important. Yeah, I guess I have to set up the Trick Room here. We'll see if I don't. I'm not gonna live. Like, he's a Charizard. I could have gone to Aromatisse. Imagine if I went into Aromatisse. Oh, we actually live, and he gets the Mummy. There, that's what I like to see. That's what I like to see. Now I think he's gonna switch here, because now we're faster. Or is he gonna stay in? I can't risk the switch because if I lose Hydreigon, it's that messes up everything. I could set up a nasty plot, because him killing me, honestly, would be a good thing, right? What if we did that? What if we set up a nasty plot? Should I do that? Alright, yeah, I'm gonna set up a nasty plot here. Alright, he's gonna stay in. So I think he went for the kill. So that means Hydreigon gets to come in, baby. No, he goes for the burst. Okay, that sucks, but we're also, like, have a lot of health now. What if he goes? I should have switched, man. Okay. We'll go for the shadow, or we'll go for the dark pulse. You know, flinches are good always. I'm so nervous, guys. I'm still so nervous. I can't believe I'm still nervous. Usually, like, as we ease into the battle, like, I get a lot better. Okay, we're gonna go for a Dark Pulse. It's gonna do over 50. Okay, he gets the Dragon Claw. Alright, so now, his plus 2 is gone, right? We can go into our Hydreigon. Now, the question here is, what is he gonna go into to eat the, I want to go for that flamethrower so bad. You have no idea. I could go for the Dark Pulse. That will kill. And we'll hit a bunch of other things. So we'll go for Dark Pulse. Removing Charizard from his field would be very ideal. I'm pretty sure Dark Pulse plus Surf will take out Hippowdon, so that's also good. Surf does about 80%, 70 to 80. Just to, like, standard sets and everything. Something's gonna go down here. Something is going to go down to Hydreigon. We have another turn of Trick Room, so. I think we played it well with Cofagrigus. He could still be alive if I pulled that Roost prediction. Okay, so we're going for our, he's gonna go into Ferrothorn. Okay, so Ferrothorn, I don't know if it out, I think it outspeeds us, unfortunately. We have Flamethrower now. Okay. I don't think he's gonna go for rocks. He might damage us, but I think we can go for the flamethrower here. He's gonna outspeed, obviously. I don't know. I feel like he's not going rocks. I feel like he has rocks on Hippo, and that's why he went for the leech seed earlier on.
And he could be predicting the switch into Zatu right now, which obviously, like I said, I'm not doing. Man, I almost went for Flamethrower, dude. I almost went for Flamethrower. It would have been a smart prediction, but it also wouldn't have been safe because I don't believe it would have killed Charizard. And like I said, like losing Hydreigon is awful. Us losing Hydreigon would be absolutely terrible. Also, random side note, we're like 300 away from 5,000, which is really awesome. I have a really awesome collaboration plan for 5k. It's not like a top 10 or anything. It's a different kind of video, which you guys will see. There's a lot of really cool, bigger PokeTubers who are going to be in it with me, so that'll be fun when that eventually comes out. I'm so nervous. The timer is so suspenseful, the amount of time it is in between turns. Just really kills me, you know. If he goes into Hippowdon, he's going for the Gyro Ball. Yeah, that doesn't do anything. Alright, so Flamethrower takes him out. I believe dimensions are going to turn back to normal now. I believe so. Yes, Twisted Dimensions return to normal. So we're at like half health, which sucks. But I think we're good for now. What is he gonna go to now? He's gonna go to Mian Chao. Alright, so he's gonna go for like the fake out or whatever. I'm fine with that. He might go for U-turn. He's probably scarfed. I'm gonna go into Aromatisse. Does this thing get Bullet Punch? It might. I don't think that'll do very much, though. I'd love it. Okay, U-turn was smart there. Him going for the Fake Out would have been a lot better for me. Because now we can go to Charizard, you see. The thing with Charizard is we could still set up a Trick Room. Like, he can't Oko us without being, like, plus two or whatever. So him going into Charizard would still be somewhat ideal. Yep, there's Charizard. Alright, so we're gonna kinda go on the suicide run here. Actually, I believe that he's gonna roost here, probably. So I can Calm Mind. What if I went Calm Mind? No, I can't risk. I gotta go for the Trick Room. Yeah, he's gonna roost, of course. Makes sense. I believe he's gonna go for Swords Dance now, to be completely honest with you. I really want to pull the risky switch into my... I want to pull the risky switch into Hydreigon. Because that would be another Pokemon down. Because he's going to go for Swords Dance here. I know he knows I can't kill him. And he can't kill me. I'm going to go into Hydreigon. We have to cross our fingers, guys. This is the game changer. It's just safe. I think we're safe. This could cost us the game 100%. Flare Blitz, yes. Okay. Should live that. Yes, there we go. Awesome. So now we can Deep Pulse. Deep Pulse will do. It will okay with Charizard. One thing that's scary is the amount of health that we have left. Especially given the fact that we have Life Orb, so it's like three attacks, kind of. Three or four. I'd love it if he stayed in, but I don't know why he would, yeah. So Dragon Pulse is gonna go off. Oh, he has... Okay, no, he's gonna have Dalman. Okay. Dragon Pulse plus Surf. Sandstream. That was smart. Okay. 8 HP. I'm gonna go into Zatu. I think he's gonna slack off. I can go into Medicham, but no. Slack off, yep. Okay, so we have Grass Knot. Grass Knot will do a good amount of damage. It won't Oko, but it will do a good amount. So I'm gonna play Grass Knot. Also, we can set up, this is our last turn of Trick Room, I believe, so we can set up another one after. I'm really afraid I messed up with Hydreigon. I'm really afraid. He's gonna go for the Stone Edge. Oh my god. I don't think he can Oko. Yeah. Okay. He's faster. It's also good that we switched out. So that does hella damage, buffeted by the Sandstorm. Is Twisted Dimensions go back to normal this turn, I believe. Okay, so I'm going to go for the Grass Knot or Trick Room, man. I mean, we outspeed, so I'm gonna go for the Grass Knot. But getting the Trick Room set up for later is just helpful. But Hippowdon is his last tank left. After that, Medicham can also run through. And we still have Aromatisse. So I'm gonna go for the Grass Knot here. This is going to be an insanely quiet battle. A lot of thinking is being put into. So my regards for the lack of commentary. I'm just awfully afraid. Oh boy. He's going to withdraw. Okay. Shooting out for Trick Room. Starmie! Okay. Well, Starmie can eat this Grass Knot. Which is not enough to kill, but he's gonna take Sandstorm, I'm gonna take some Sandstorm. He should be able to Oko us here, unfortunately, but I'm gonna set up Trick Room. He's got leftovers. Yeah, we'll set up Trick Room here. He's probably gonna take us out. So after this, that'd be two of our three Trick Room setters down. So I'd have to go into Aromatisse and set it up and then switch. And the sand is still a very big problem for us. Not to mention how frail Medicham is, so he's gonna go for the Skull, that should be enough. Yeah, okay. I'd love it if the sand- oh, he saved Hippowdon because of the Sandstorm. We get into Aromatisse now, and I'm just gonna set. I mean, would he switch into something here? I'll just Trick Room. How much HP does this Charizard have? I completely forget. I think it's at like almost full. Yeah, I'm a Trick Room. He's going for the Toxic. Okay, that's whatever. We get the free Trick Room, so that's all that matters. I can honestly Calm Mind here. Probably has recovery, so. Setting up a Calm Mind, we could get some good damage onto Charizard. Because I know he can't Oko us. So So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and calm mind. He's gonna probably switch into Charizard here. I don't see why he wouldn't. I don't know what else he'd go into. Okay, he stays in, so he might have gone for the recovery. I understand that. However, at the same time, I know he can't like be taking me out too easily. So I can just stay in here, set up some calm minds while he continues to recover. Actually, I can't do that because of toxic. Okay. So yeah, he went for the recovery. Makes sense. I'm now gonna go into. One of my lights just burned out, I think. What the hell? Okay, yeah, I'm gonna Moonblast here. Definitely a play to go with. I'd love to lower his special attack, that'd be cool. Honestly, if this doesn't kill him, I'd be, in a sense, happy, because I can set up another Trick Room before he takes me out. And go into Medicham. Because at this point, Medicham can take out everything he has as well. So I guess we'll see what happens. I'm still incredibly nervous, man. You have no idea. I mean, it looks like we're down a lot, but, you know, we still have, like, quite a good amount of... He has so much recovery on his team, by the way. Like, random fact, he has... Doesn't Mianchal even get recovery? Obviously, Charizard Roost, Starmie Recover, and Slack Off on the Hippowdon. Still extremely terrified of this battle. I think we're doing okay, though. We're almost halfway through the battle timer. So that's a thing. He's going to withdraw. Okay, so we get the free Moonblast off on Charizard. Hippowdon. Okay, well, Hippowdon's dead. That's the good news. Now he gets to go into Charizard, right? Okay. I might have to sack off... Oh, boy. On it... Okay, is... We still have one turn of Twisted Dimensions, right? We still have one more turn of Trick Room, I think. If he goes into Starmie or Helioptile, I am going to set up a Calm Mind. Because there's one more turn of Trick Room. And what he wants to do is bait out Trick Room, right? He wants it to where I can no longer do Trick Room. So if I get it to the point where Toxic is going to kill me after like an attack from his Helioptile or something, I get a free switch into either Medicham or Hydreigon. Also, Donphan is kind of like our late game sweeper in a way. Luckily, Rocks is... Off, that's not gonna happen at this point, so we don't need to worry about losing our Sturdy. Man. One thing that's good is, I'm not sure, after Rock Polish, will Donphan outspeed Charizard? Because he's not using Dragon Dance, right? He's using Sword Dance. This might be the longest battle I've ever had. No joke. So yeah, Hippowdon's gone. Going into Charizard, you know, we're just able to kind of Moonblast. And I don't know if it's in KO range, but we are plus one, luckily, so. It could be, you don't know. But I'm sure Vump is getting ready to pick what Pokemon he brings in. We need this sand to go away. That is much important. He's gonna go into Starmie. There we go, that's what I thought. Okay, so now we set up a Calm Mind. Hee hee. Oh, it has like natural cure or whatever. Okay, no, he was at this amount of health. Okay, yeah, so we go for Calm Mind here. Let Trick Room go away. Set up another Trick Room next turn. He can't 2-hit KO us. Can he after? What if he can? Then we would lose. Should I have set up Trick Room, man? I have no idea. I mean, we're plus two Calm Mind, like, come on. Scald. Nothing. Okay, nothing. Yes. Sandstorm hits both of us. It's whatever. Now we get the trick room up, baby. That's what I like to see. Those are called strats. And Sandstorm is about to go away. Probably, if not this turn, next turn. Toxic does a fair amount, but not enough for Skull to take us out. Okay, so now we trick room. He goes for the recover. And there's Trick Room, baby. Now, the fact that he went for that recover is honestly what makes me somewhat afraid that he might be sashed. But, oh no, no, his sash is broken. What am I talking about? How long is this goddamn sandstorm gonna last, okay? After Toxic, do we go down? Oh no, he has leftovers as well, damn. Okay. We have our lefties. We should live, dude, we should. I don't think Toxic has done enough to take 61. No, okay, we're down. Aromatisse is out. But we got the Trick Room. What? Thunder Punch. We're gonna Mega Evolve, of course, and go for that Thunder Punch. I don't think he's sashed. Why would he be sashed? He's definitely not sashed. Stop psyching yourself out, Luke. Even if he is sashed. Sandstorm will kill him. Unless he, like, recovers. But then I can kill him next turn. But then that's also Trick Room stall. We have young Medi out here, guys. And, you know, we've seen through the season, Medicham is really good. It's put in a ton of work. Medicham and Bisharp and Magmortar have put in the most work. Unfortunately, Bisharp and Magmortar didn't really put in that much in this battle. So, and, like, with Trick Room, Bisharp is a thing, and it's pretty good, but I decided not to include it this time around. So, yeah. Alright, what's he gonna go into? Pick something, please. My heart is pounding still, man. You have no idea how important this battle is to me. We're now 30 minutes into it. Almost. 29 minutes. 29 minutes and 25 seconds. Man, oh man. It's gonna withdraw. Okay, so we're gonna Thunder Punch, like, something random. Mian Chao. Will Thunder Punch Oko? I don't think it will. What if I had Jump Kicked, man? So he's gonna fake out and waste a turn of. Damn. So close, man, so close! Ah, you have no idea how close that was. I mean, obviously, I think. Honestly, I might as well just. Might as well just Thunder Punch again. He's gonna fake out. Oh, he goes for the. Okay, so he's slower. That does, like, nothing. Thunder Punch takes him out. Yes. Okay, we have another turn of Trick Room. We need to get rid of Starmie. Need. I mean, need. Sandstorm is gone. But it doesn't even matter at this point. Hydreigon is out of here. This is intense, guys. Unless I miscounted my Trick Room teams, or number of turns till Trick Room's over. Donphan? Actually, with Rock Polish Up, Donphan might be able to do something. With a Rock Polish Up, Donphan Donphan can certainly take out Charizard, Helioptile. Unless it's like Scarfed. Scarftile. I'd have to risk it though. Minutes into the battle, it's crazy. I believe it's 3-3 at this point. It's gonna go Heliolisk. Okay. What's still scaring me is that Starmie, man. You have no idea. Okay, so we're gonna have a jump kick here. He's gonna Volt Switch. Not enough. He's gonna go into Starmie now. I should have Thunder Punched. Damn it. And that's Trick Room. And it misses too. I have to go on the Donphan. Is there... What if there's another turn of Trick Room left? There is, isn't there? God damn it. Okay. Knock off. No, there wasn't. I think I just messed up the game at this point, guys. I think it's over. I should have rock polished. Damn it, damn it, damn it. I thought I miscounted. But yeah, this should be it. So yeah, he's gonna go for Surf here. I'll rock polish just in case. Man, if I rock polish, I could have won. Just in case, like, I don't know. Surf, yeah. Yeah, that should be game, guys. Damn, that was a hell of a good battle. That was a hell of a good battle. Props to Vump, man. I don't know if that rock polish even would have mattered. I'm gonna assume it would have, and I'm gonna hate myself for the rest of my life for that. But hey, who knows? Yeah, he's gonna Volt Switch. Okay, so he's not even Scarfed. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed National Pokemon Association Season 2. You know, we played really well. Unfortunately, we did get taken out in our first playoff match. But hey, you know, I'm proud of my improvements. Vump wins 2-0. All props to him, guys. Check out Vump's channel in the description below. He's a really awesome guy. Congratulations to the San Diego Chargers, no. San Diego Charizards for taking that dub. Yeah, I'll see you guys all in the next video. Probably no Wi-Fi battles for a really long time. But yeah, I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed the NPA Season 2. I know I had a lot of fun in it. Shoutouts to everyone who took part in it. It was awesome. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.